if you're the kind of person that does not want to connect your PayPal to QuickBooks, but you do want to upload the data, no problem. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do that using Excel. So first, this is the data that I exported from PayPal into Excel. The only thing that I did was go and put minus signs in front of the things where money was taken out of my account. You have to do that. If you don't do that, you're just going to end up with issues. I know, because this is my second time recording the video. The first time, I'm like, why doesn't the math work? And then I'm like, right, totally my fault. So put in your minus signs. You can work this out any way that you want, but you've got to set it up in such a way that you can tell QuickBooks, here's the money that comes into PayPal and here's the money that comes out of PayPal. Let me just save this and go to my QuickBooks. When I'm in QuickBooks, I need to go to transactions and then to bank transactions. I currently do not have any sort of little box for my PayPal account. So I'm going to click this drop down that says upload from file. I'm going to drag and drop my file and then continue. This is saying, where should this data go within your QuickBooks? And the answer for me is my QuickBooks balance account. If you don't have a PayPal account, you can click on add new and add a PayPal account. So I will do that. I'll say continue. And then it says how many columns show the amounts. If you remember from earlier, there's really two columns. There was the gross and then the fees and then, of course, the net. I'm going to upload this data twice. And so the first time I'm going to say one column. My dates look like this. My description, I'm going to choose type. Although you can pick whatever you want for the description to import. My amount, the first time I do this, I'm going to use the gross column. I'm going to say continue. I'm going to look at this and then look at my, I've got it open on my second screen. I'm like, yep, $319 comes in, $98 goes out. So I do not need to reverse my values. I will select all. I'll choose continue. And I'm just importing everything that shows up in that first column. What doesn't show up in the first column is the fees. So I've made multiple videos. That's why we have all these matches. I just want to make sure that everything shows up in its right column. Let me do this again. I'm going to upload from file. I'm going to drag my CSV over, continue, and PayPal, continue. Dates like this, description, and then the amount is going to be the fee column, and then continue. There's only two with fees, and I'm like, yep, add that one and add that one. Continue. Yes. Done. Okay. So now it's uploaded and it's available here for me to organize and do my magic. I want you to see, QuickBooks does this and it drives me a little bit bonkers. I have 10 things. We know we have 10 things because you just watched me, but it says it's displaying 1 of 8. So this is one of those times we get to refresh and give QuickBooks a stern look. Okay. So now it says 1 of 10. Let me go ahead and click on this one right here because I want you to see this memo express checkout payment that came from the Excel document. So from here, you likely know what to do with these things. And if you don't, I definitely have videos to walk through it. What I want to do is go back to the Excel document and just reiterate where the information came from on Excel and where it went to in QuickBooks. If this is all you need to know, you can stop here because the rest of it will be just a hair boring. The first time I uploaded my data, I said, grab the data from the column called the gross column. I said, all my values are in one column and my positives are positive and my negatives are negatives. I said, hey, you know, for the description, go ahead and put whatever's in the type column. If I wanted a better, different description, I would just modify the Excel document before I uploaded it, so that I could pick whatever column had my better description. When I re-uploaded and I said, okay, all of my information or my dollars or my amounts, they're in the fee column. That's what I've got right here. This should have been negatives. So pretend like they were negatives when I uploaded it. A hazard of uploading stuff from Excel is that if you're me, you're gonna get your positives and negatives reversed. What you could do if you had a bunch of data, if you didn't want to upload it twice, is you certainly can copy down the fees and make a second set of information and then upload everything all at once. I don't. I think it's way faster for me to upload my gross and then upload my fees. But really, it depends on the situation. If you have, like in this case, I just have a couple. I might do this. I might hand enter them. I might connect it to QuickBooks. If I'm working with a client that has hundreds of sales per month, I'm going to be real careful about my positives and negatives. And two, I'm definitely going to organize my Excel in such a way that it's nice and it's efficient and it's perfect for me. And then I'm going to upload it and I'm going to reconcile that statement 1 month at a time. So hopefully this is helpful. I just wanted you to see, here's a way you can take data from PayPal and get it into QuickBooks. At this point, I've shown a handful of different ways, and the videos will get released one at a time. But I really wanted you to see different options, because it's no different than making the perfect dessert. The way that I make perfect dessert might be different than the way you make perfect dessert, but it doesn't matter as long as we have a perfect dessert. I don't care how you get your data into QuickBooks. I just want you to see and have options for what might work for you. If you have questions, if you need help, let me know. Post them in the comments. I'm happy to answer what I can. If you need anything specific, then I'll just suggest you book time with me. If you want to see kind of a generic video that might be helpful to yourself and others, let me know. I'm happy to add it to the to-do list. Okay, thanks.